Carry
Ah,
on.
excellent. So my talk about genus Laurelus from sub-Saharan Africa and Madagascar. And let me explain firstly what sub-Saharan Africa means. This is the part of African continent that lies south from Sahara Desert. It also includes multiple archipelagos and islands such as Madagascar, Seychelles, Cabo Verde, etc. I stuck with the geographical and geographical meanings instead of political. South border of Sahara Desert is also south border of Western Palearctic. So I actually deal with most of Afrotropics. Genus Laurelus contains of 73 species, including two subspecies. 50 species known from both sexes, 13 from males and 10 from females only. Laurelus species known only from Old World. They distributed mostly in Palearctic with 41 species. 9 species occur in Afrotropics and only 3 species in Oriental region. Type species, Laurelus sphenoincidentus describes from Sweden by Clerk back in 1757. Unfortunately, type specimens is lost, but the detailed description of and features of male-like pattern on eye region can easily allow us to identify specimens as Laurelus sphenoincidentus. Modern centers of species diversity of Laurelus lies in Mediterranean, in Middle Asian part of Palearctic. 34 species in Mediterranean and 12 species in Middle Asia, with 4 shared species, Laurelus concolor, Leuctosus, M. nigrum, and sphenoincidentus. 11 species among Mediterranean are known from North Africa. Sub-Saharan Africa and Madagascar contain 9 species. 2 from West Africa, Laurelus catus from Senegal and Laurelus rasa smithii from Ivory Coast. 4 from East Africa, Laurelus minutus from Eritrea, Laurelus subafinis and Laurelus tumidulus, both from Ethiopia, and Laurelus rugatus from Tanzania. 2 species known from Southern Africa, Laurelus mirabilis from Namibia and Laurelus cristatopalpus from South Africa. And 1 species, Laurelus madagascariensis from Madagascar. Follow characters are unique for Laurelus among all Laureliens and jumped spiders in general. For males, embolic division U-shaped contains embolus and terminal apophysis connected to each other by a membrane. Tip of terminal apophysis is an important taxonomical character to distinguish group of species. For example, petals shaped in TA in sphenoincidentus group and curved with many spurs on its rim in Eruginosus group. And for females, epigyna is always with epigynal wings and pocket. Capillary opening located in anterior part of epigyna. Position of capillary openings and shape of wings are important taxonomical characters to distinguish species, groups of species too. let's jump to African, sub-Saharan Laurelus. Laurelus catus described from male from Senegal by Simon. Unfortunately, he provided only short description without any images. According to Simon's description, especially a tibial apophysis, small, elegant, apex slightly curved dorsally. This species can be possible member of genera Manzuma or Stenolaurelus. Members of Laurelus are always with 2 retrolateral tibial apophyses, sometimes dorsal apophysis slightly undeveloped, but it always there. This species needs further investigation. Of course, the best way to resolve this issue is study type material, which probably kept in Paris. So Christine, I will ask you about this type later. Ellurius rugatus, described from female from Tanzania. Bösenberg and Lenz provided description as well as drawings. According to drawings, this is clearly not Ellurius or even Ellurilina, probably Chrysalina or something else. This species apparently should be transferred to other genus. Ellurius mirabilis, described from both sexes from Namibia by Wieselowska in 2006. Conformation of copulatory organs are different from that of Ellurius. In males, palpal tibia with only one apophysis, embolic division almost forming circle and terminal apophysis reduced. In females, capillary openness located on the side of epigenal plate, which is unusual for Ellurius, where capillary openings are always located close to each other. This species belong to new undescribed Ellurilina genus. Actually, there are a few species from Southern Africa. Most of them are still undescribed. They all should be placed together in a new genus, and I'm working on it. Ellurius cristata palpus. This species described from male from South Africa. Conformation of male's pulp is different to that of Ellurius. Palpal tibia with one apophysis, cymbium with a long basal process. It's here. And embolic divisions coiled. All of these characters are untypical for Ellurius. Ellurius cristata palpus, together with a few species already described in genus Langona, as well as many still undescribed, should be placed in a new Ellurilina genus. I'm also working on. Five other species, Ellurius madagascariensis, Ellurius minutus, Ellurius russell-smithii, Ellurius subafinis, and Ellurius tumidulus are true Ellurius. You can see on this slide that it fits characters of Ellurius well. And during digging through Murphy's collection that Dimitri sent to me some time ago, of Ellurilina's collection from Kenya, I found one vial with tiny male, about 3-4 millimeters. And it was undescribed Ellurilus species, true one. It belongs to Wayne Sigintus group. A paper on description of this species will be submitted to Arachnology Journal in number of the Murphy and Roberts Memorial Symposium. So after this species will be described and other species transferred to different genera, sub-Saharan Africa will contain 10 true Ellurilus species, as you can see on this map. In Senegal, Ivory Coast, Eritrea, Ethiopia, Kenya, Tanzania, Namibia, South Africa, and Madagascar. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Galina. So colleagues, we definitely